now that your roster looks to be at least mostly complete, what have your initial thoughts been? LeBron James.
My initial thoughts with what?
Just the roster composition, the additions, and of course LeBron.
I'm excited. Obviously, we got some players that know how to win, some players that are going to come in and fit in nice with our young players and really help speed up the process of what we've been doing. I think our young guys have done an outstanding job of setting the foundation of who we are, the way we work, the way we play, and now we have some new vets that are going to come in and help win some more games for us.
What advice did
Tyree
give you when you guys had dinner?
Well, it wasn't as much advice as it was just kind of breaking down his relationship with LeBron, and he had nothing but great things to say. Honestly, he said you're going to love coaching him. He's a winner. He works hard. One of the smartest players he's ever coached. We got into Rondo a little bit too. Ty Lue coached Rondo in Boston. Said some really nice things about him too. So it wasn't as much advice, just trying to gather as much information on all the new guys that I can.
He likes to collaborate with his players, like with LeBron, with Ty. He was saying that he likes to collaborate with them, and that's a thing that LeBron was really good at, like, and that's something that you have talked before about liking to do if you have players who can like meet you at that level. Is it going to be fun for you to have someone that you can bounce ideas back and forth with that understands the game as well as LeBron does?
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that. You know, I think, you know, and not just him, but, you know, Rondo and with the young guys too. You know, even during the season, I'm talking to Brandon about different things when we moved him to the point guard spot. To me, teams are at the best when they take ownership of that team, and the best way to do that is to include them in decisions and in the way that we're going to play and try to use their strengths, but also their minds into what we do. And then when everyone's bought in on the same page, then it's you know, easy to hold them accountable, and then most of the times they hold themselves accountable too. So really excited to start working with, yes, LeBron, but also the other guys, and get our young guys back too. Well, I don't know, modern conversation. We've texted a bunch. I don't know if that counts as conversations or not, but you know, he's obviously been on vacation, and there's not much. He just got done playing a little bit ago, so I'm not in a rush. I told him whenever he's ready, let me know. So we'll meet soon.
Luke, how did you first hear that LeBron was coming, and how did you react?
I was sitting in my backyard on a nice Sunday afternoon, and my phone started blowing up, and I didn't know if it was fake news or real news, but I guess it was real, and it was. I was obviously, you know, really, really excited about it. I kind of had a gut feeling this is where he was going to come, so I wasn't shocked, but it was a fun Sunday.
How much of your style of play is going to have to change next season from what you did last year to this year?
You know, we'll change some things. As far as how much, it's too early to determine. But, you know, it's a coach's job. There's some things you don't change, and that's, what builds your culture, who we are as an organization. But the style of play changes. You should change it depending on your personnel. So we'll take a deep dive into all the new guys and see what's best for the group we have.
Where were you on Saturday night when, Saturday night when the free agency opened, were you at the office?
Yeah. On that 9 p.m., I was in the office, yeah.
Did you know that the Magic was over at LeBron's house?
No.
When you heard about that, what did you think?
I was excited. Magic, I saw him the next morning. He told me where he was, and I know Magic, and I know he's good at closing deals, so he didn't tell me that they agreed on anything, but he said he felt good about it. So when Magic told me he felt good about it, then I felt good about it as well.
How do you feel like the young players that you've had who've been able to kind of come along slowly are going to respond to the challenge of needing to be at LeBron's level?
Great. Honestly, I think part of what I'm hearing from other coaches is one of the things that makes LeBron so great is he picks up every single person he plays with, and he elevates their game. So I know who our young players are, and I know what they're about, and they're all excited that he's here. And I think the type of players they are and the type of workers they are, they're gonna have a really good year. And obviously, it's gonna take time, like every new team that's together, but that's part of the fun of and joy of the process is getting these pieces to fit. But I think LeBron will make that easier.
He's excited about the idea that there could be lineups that you have where you have five guys that can all be ball handlers. What do you think of that, and like how?
I love it. The more decision makers, the better. As long as they're all, you know, playing the unselfish style of basketball that we want to play, and I think that we have a lot of guys that are willing to do that. So we'll try all sorts of different lineups as we go, see what works, see what doesn't work. But you know, when you get multiple decision makers that have the ability that some of our players have, it puts a lot of pressure on the other team's defense, because they're always having to recover, and guys are going to be moving and cutting. It just gives you that much, you know, that much more of a threat on the offensive end to score easy buckets.
Last question, please. He's never really been on a team where the ball's out of, like, he's the primary ball handler on most of the teams he's been on. So
we're gonna have the ball in LeBron's hands a lot.
It sounded like part of the idea is to take some of that off, like to get free him up a little bit to be off the ball more. Do you envision it working like that a little bit, or?
Yeah, well, I envision obviously everyone making plays, but he's going to have the ball a lot during the game. Yeah.
Can you just give us your take on Mo, Isaac, and
Speed? They've been great, and Josh Hart too. Josh has been incredible. Josh came to us, told us he wanted to play, all these games, and I think he's really done a good job of showing what hard work he's put in and what kind of player he is.
Thank you.